The net loss of Russia's gas monopoly, Gazprom, in the first half of 2024 amounted to more than 480 billion rubles. This is almost double the loss recorded during the same period last year. Russian media report this, citing the company's financial statements.
All of Gazprom's Western European infrastructure, all these extended pipelines, has become deeply unprofitable. They now have only two options. The first is to build gas chemical complexes and develop the ones they already have. The second option is to gasify villages and cities in Russia. Both options require huge financial investments. Therefore, transit through Ukraine is vital for Gazprom.
According to experts, the main reasons for the record loss of Russia's gas monopoly are sharp reduction by 56% compared to 2022 in gas supplies to EU countries due to Russia's invasion of Ukraine, and increased financial burdens on the company due to an additional increase in the mineral extraction tax. Russia wants to compensate for the reduction in pipeline supplies with liquefied natural gas by sea. In 2023, Russia exported 33 million tons of LNG, and by 2027, the Federation plans to increase supplies to 56 million. But this is unlikely to succeed, since in November 2023, the US imposed restrictions on a number of companies and vessels involved in Russian LNG projects.
Gazprom is now supported only by consumers who are already starting to raise prices for utilities, hot water and so on. This is a social revolt, and it's clear why it has become expensive, because there are no compensatory mechanisms. When you sold something expensive abroad and cheaply distributed this gas to your vassals and slaves within the country.
In the 14th sanction package, the EU banned the use of EU facilities for transshipment of Russian LNG to third countries. Analysts claim that this will not deal a crushing blow to the industry, but will significantly reduce the revenues Russia receives from the sale and transportation of LNG.
This covers ship-to-ship transshipment, shore transportation and reloading operations, and does not affect imports, but only re-exports to said countries through the EU. The European Commission will monitor the implementation of this decision and may propose mitigating measures if necessary. In addition, the EU will prohibit new investments and the provision of goods, technologies and services for the completion of LNG projects such as Arctic LNG 2 and Murmansk LNG. Restrictions are being imposed on the import of Russian LNG through EU terminals not connected to the natural gas system, from the European Council website.
Finance ministers from 8 EU countries stated that Western sanctions have hit the Kremlin military machine. They call for increased pressure on the Putin regime. The column was signed by the finance and economy ministers of Sweden, Denmark, Estonia, Finland, Latvia, Lithuania, the Netherlands, and Poland.
It is particularly necessary to strengthen control over compliance with the price cap on Russian crude oil, as trade above the $60 per barrel cap still continues. It is also important to impose mirror sanctions against Belarus and increase pressure on other major sanctions evaders in East Asia and the Middle East, from an article by The Guardian.
After being pushed out of the European market, Moscow had high hopes for China. China imports about 23 billion cubic meters of gas annually, but this is only 1/9 of pre-war Russian exports to Europe. The Kremlin is actively negotiating to increase supplies, but Beijing is not interested in allocating too large a share of its market to Russia. Additionally, China insists on lowering the price, despite it already being a third lower than European prices. Furthermore, Russia is increasing gas cooperation with Iran for further export to India and Pakistan, but experts argue that the Kremlin will not gain significant benefits from this. Viktor and Victoria Smirnova for Freedom TV channel.